And a very good Monday to each and every one of you. I hope everything's going real well for you. My name is Jewel, and this is the Weather Channel of J7409. Sorry I hadn't been around yesterday, not too much the day before. I've just been feeling really puny, folks, and I'd appreciate all your prayers, okay? Now, as we're looking at the radar right here, here is Claudette. All right, you see a timestamp down here. I've got this set for the future. Now, you see that little curvature there? That was the spinning of the center of Claudette. It went right over my house. Most of the precipitation was on the east side of me, which was a good thing. However, though, yesterday afternoon, we did have some tornado spin up in the area and the surrounding counties. But I'm fine. Everything's fine. Now, as this goes through, I want to show you something like today. As this goes up around Virginia, you see these storms headed your way. You could get some more thunderstorm activity out of this. Also, you see what's going on down around Florida, Louisiana. And the big thing that's coming up, we do have severe weather today. You can see where it is in all of these places. Let it run through again. I'll stop it because this is going to go on out to sea, okay? Claudette's going to go on out to sea. And while this is right here, I want to get back to right around here. For those of you who follow me, if you remember, one day last week I said, don't be surprised if something down around the island areas don't show up. Well, it's showing up. We're going over to the National Hurricane Center in just a moment and check it out. But this is going to be the big, big story. You see, this is around 2:45 EDT this afternoon. This line of squalls are going to line up, and we're going to have some severe weather out of it for these areas, which I will show you with the severe weather in a moment. And this is going to drape on across. And for North Carolina, all the states up in this area, we're going to know it. Now, for eastern North Carolina, by tomorrow, we're going to get some more very heavy rain and probably more wind than we saw with Claudette. We could have some winds tomorrow gusting up to 50 miles per hour. Now over to the National Hurricane Center. Here is Claudette. The winds are back up to 40 miles per hour as it progresses off the coast of North Carolina. The minimum central pressure, you know, this is one thing. It's still 1,007 millibars. The pressure in this never dropped that much, but yet it still became a tropical storm. It was still a tropical storm even when it was just a tad lower than this, but it's keeping on building up, but it should disintegrate after a while and move on out to sea. It's located at 35.6 north, 77.6 west. For those of you who went through Florence with me, you know my coordinates are 35.6 north and 77.6 west. Now, this is right where it was over me, and the eye mostly was over me, or I should say the center of circulation. It never really had an eye. It's booking, folks, 25 miles per hour east-northeast. Now, here we go to this system that I spied out last week. It's a well-defined tropical wave. It's about 900 miles east-southeast of the Windward Islands. It is producing some disorganized showers and thunderstorms, and some development of this disturbance will be possible during the next couple of days. But then it's looking like the upper-level winds are going to kind of get into it and make it less conducive for further organization by Thursday. However, we need to watch this, and I will keep my eyes on it for you, okay? It should move west to west-northwest around 15 miles per hour. As of today, it's a low chance of formation, 20% for 2 days and 5 days. But I will keep my eyes on this and make sure it does dissipate, and I will keep everybody informed on what's going on with it. Don't be surprised if we don't start seeing more and more of these coming off the coast of Africa slowly but surely, because we're getting closer and closer to July. Now, you saw all of these storm cells coming through with the cold front that's going to be pushing through, and that's what's going to make severe weather, folks. And we do have isolated, scattered severe thunderstorms that are expected from the upper Ohio Valley and the Mid-Atlantic into the north portions of New England, the northern portions of New England. Now, what's going to accompany these storms? Well, folks, we got the whole bag. Damaging wind gusts, severe hail, and tornadoes are all possible. Where's the tornado threat? Mostly for northern Pennsylvania, a large portion of New York, Vermont, New Hampshire, moving up into the western sections of Maine. This is a 5% chance you could have a tornado pop up. The most damaging wind gusts go down to portions of West Virginia, portions of Northern Virginia, and of course, eastern and southern and mid areas of Ohio, moving right on up into a large portion of Pennsylvania, New York, right on up into northern Maine. This is where damaging wind gusts could be very well felt for today. And so far as the large hail, it's looking like northern Pennsylvania, a large portion of New York, Vermont, New Hampshire, moving up into western sections of Maine. So if any of this severe weather comes your way, please make sure you have a safe spot to get to. Here we have a look at my future radar as I turn it on and let it play. You see the timestamps. You know the front I'm talking about, the cold front that's coming. It's going to produce these showers and thunderstorms over the northeast and the severe thunderstorms over parts of the northeast, northern mid-Atlantic, and parts of Ohio valleys, and even parts of the central Appalachians through Tuesday morning. Now, all of the hazards, once again, I can't stress this enough with these thunderstorms, frequent lightning, severe thunderstorm wind gusts, hail, and tornadoes. And it's also looking like the severe thunderstorm threat could weaken a bit at some point Tuesday along the Mid-Atlantic and Southeast, but we're going to have excessive rainfall threats. They should diminish by tomorrow evening or tomorrow night. Now, Claudette is moving eastward, as I've showed you, off of the North Carolina coast today. It's then going to move northeastward over the western Atlantic off the northeast coast toward the Canadian Maritimes by Wednesday. And Claudette will produce some heavy rain over parts of the Outer Banks through the morning hours, and then it should diminish on out and be a good afternoon. Elsewhere, heat, it's still going on over most of the western U.S., folks. It should end as the temperature becomes more average. However, there is the potential for record-breaking high minimum temperatures across the northwest once again today, and the combination of heat and exceptional drought is also leading to fire weather concerns throughout the Great Basin and parts of the southwest. That should continue through Wednesday. The red flag warnings are up and in effect across parts of Utah, western Colorado, and northwestern Nevada. Thanks so much for watching, my friends. If you're into the weather and you haven't subscribed and you like daily weather forecast updates on all tropical systems of any sort, please subscribe, click that bell, and check off all to make sure you get all my latest weather videos. I would appreciate it very, very, very much. I'm wishing each of you a good day, a safe day, a blessed day, and much peace, love, and kindness to each and every one of you. Thanks for watching.